So in this lesson, we're going to learn a little bit about grep. Grep stands for Global Regular Expression Print. And grep is a useful tool for searching the contents of files or possibly file names or in combinations with things like pipes or redirects to perform searches on outputs for specific patterns. And those patterns are combinations of regular expressions. So the structure of a grep command is much like the structure of any other Unix command. We first type grep, followed by a space, followed by a series of options, followed by the pattern. This is the regular expression itself. This is the regular expression itself, followed by any file names which we want to search. And this file names could be replaced by the output of a pipe command. So here's a table of various options we can use. The dash I ignores cases. The dash V sort of is the opposite or a negation. So it displays lines that don't match the expression. Dash N displays the nine line numbers in the file that where the match was found. The dash C counts the occurrences. Dash L lists the file names only. So this would be if you're searching multiple files for something, that would list the file names only. Dash E is just this is useful when you have multiple regular expressions that you're matching. So you'd say dash E and then one regular expression and then dash E and possibly another. The dash X matches the entire pattern with the entire line, and F takes patterns from a file, one per line. So if you had a whole bunch of regular expressions that you're trying to match, very complicated things, you could put them in a file and then use it that way. So here's some comments. You can use regular expressions and patterns and file names. So if you were looking for the match here, this would match either Woodhouse or Wodehouse, is not really a name, in all C programs. So this is just an example. Grep works great with pipe, so we can say list what's in user bin and then search what's in there for possibly GCC. So that's just explanation of that. It works well with find, execute, and OK. We'll give an example of that. So in other words, you can use find to find a particular file. And then once you've found that file, you can search inside that file for something, for some regular expression. And also, you should just know about Perl. There's a Perl script called ACK, which is installed on lots of Linux machines, or can be installed rather easily. And it takes most of the options that grep does and replaces most of the functionality of grep, but it's a little more advanced, in particular in how it prints the output in a somewhat better way. So let's go look at a couple examples over here. If we just start, there's a file called etsy password, which has some information about all the users of the machine. There's not a lot of users on Cloud9 here, however, but we could say use grep to search for our own username. So our username on these Cloud9 machines is Ubuntu, so we're going to grep. What we're actually looking for, the regular expression in this case, is Ubuntu. And then we can search for it. So that reports the match. And you see the pattern there in red. The actual word Ubuntu was matched. We could also add the dash N option. And that will report the line. So you can see that on line 21 is where the match was found. We could also say we don't know the case of what we're looking for, so we could say grep. We'll print the line number again, and we'll say ignore case. This time we'll search for the word server. So this will include any upper or lowercase letters in server. And we'll look in at etsy password there. And so you see there it reports three lines, one in which server is uppercase, and then two is which in it's lowercase. Again, let's say we didn't know exactly where to find this file, etsy password, that we've been searching in. We can combine it with find. So what we could do is we can say find. We're only going to search the etsy directory, and we'll also specify max depth 1 just to make the search quick. The file we're looking for will be called password, right? And we know that that exists because we've been calling it. But now what we can do is continue on and execute grep-i-n server. And so then we see the same output. So this is a combination of using find and grep at the same time. Again, we can use it in combination with listing things. So we can list the contents of user bin, and you see there's quite a bit in there. And so it would be very difficult to just visually look through there and find what you need. So we might choose to then pipe the output of user bin into grep, ignoring case and searching for GCC. And then you can see all the instances of GCC, which is a compiler. Okay. So now let's just look at one more example with using a slightly more complex regular expression. I have this file here that I call names.txt, and what's in it is two names, and you can imagine there's a whole lot more. John Foster and Jim Forrester in this case. And let's say that we're looking for these two names in this file, and imagine there are many more names, and you know, it was too difficult to search for them individually, so we could actually use grep then to search in this file, and using a more complicated regular expression, we could have it search for, it's going to be FO, the pattern will be FO, and then either R or S, and then either 0 or one instance of E, I'm sorry, 0 or many instances of E, 0 or many instances of S, and then say TER, and then the file names.txt. And you see that in this case, it found both because of our regular expression was complicated enough to capture both. So again, there are many, many more. We had a separate lesson on regular expressions, which you can refer to, or Google, or the man pages of grep to learn how to use these tools in more depth.